It looks like Germany might have cracked the secret formula for limitless energy with their new nuclear fusion reactor. The fact that nuclear fusion does not rely on fossil fuels or produce harmful greenhouse gases changes everything we know about nuclear energy. Nuclear fusion is what gives the sun its energy, and ever since the 1960s, scientists from more than 50 countries have been trying to recreate the process of nuclear fusion on Earth. But all of their efforts were futile. But it looks like Germany's new nuclear fusion reactor is here to change the future of renewable sources of energy. So keep watching till the end to know more about what Germany has under their sleeves and how the country will change the face of nuclear energy. You cannot deny the fact that the world now needs more renewable sources of energy than ever before, even though the majority of the energy that we use today still comes from traditional fossil fuels. Renewable energy is produced from what is available in the natural environment, and that it can be replenished almost an infinite number of times. For instance, solar energy is something that's naturally available, and we will never run out of it by consuming it. But that is not the case with fossil fuels. We are burning fossil fuels like oil and coal, and their reserves are depleting at an alarming rate, while also producing several greenhouse gases. Scientists already estimate that the total remaining oil resources might last for about another 190 years or so, and natural gas sources for another 230 years. Today, we have electric cars and we tend to own so many gadgets, and all of them require energy to run. Unfortunately, even today, only 16% of the total energy comes from renewable sources of energy, but that is constantly changing, especially in countries with no pro-renewable energy policies. So what is the best way to deal with such insane energy demand? Well, the answer to that would be the use of a renewable source of energy that can be used through the year. Yes, nuclear energy. The efficiency of energy conversion devices is extremely important if we are prioritizing the existing renewable energy sources over non-renewable sources of energy, which is not the case with other renewable energy sources out there. That's exactly why nuclear energy is touted to be the most practical and cleanest form of energy. Today's reactors use nuclear fission to create nuclear energy because it's a lot easier than nuclear fusion. In nuclear fusion, pairs of atoms are heated and forced together to make one heavier one. However, with nuclear fission, it's just the opposite, where the heavy atoms are split apart, which requires less energy to break down compared to fusion. But why exactly is everyone after nuclear fusion instead of fission? Well, nuclear fission produces a lot of radioactive waste, which are extremely dangerous if they're not stored safely, and they can remain that way for hundreds of years. The waste produced by nuclear fusion, on the other hand, is less radioactive and decays much more quickly. Traditional fossil fuel-based energy sources are known for pumping massive amounts of carbon dioxide, the primary cause for global climate change, into the atmosphere. But nuclear energy power plants, on the other hand, don't produce carbon dioxide or any other polluting agents during its operation. But the process of mining and preparing uranium uses energy and nuclear waste also poses a completely separate environmental problem. Nuclear fusion, on the other hand, uses hydrogen, which can be extracted cheaply from seawater, and lithium, which means fuel supplies could last for millions of years, which is the reason why nuclear fusion is definitely the holy grail of energy production. Nuclear fusion is all about heating and combining two atoms of light elements, such as hydrogen, to form single heavy elements, such as helium. The reaction produces massive amounts of energy, which can be captured. But the true challenge lies in getting two identical elements to combine because they have the exact same charge, just like two positive ends of the battery, where they tend to repel each other. So in order to make fusion happen, you need a lot of energy to overcome this resistance. But how exactly does that happen in the sun? Well, the sun has a temperature of 10 million degrees Celsius and a significant pressure of 100 billion times more than Earth's atmosphere. Scientists have already tried different techniques to recreate those conditions on our planet, but it was extremely difficult for them to maintain the high temperature and pressure for over long periods of time. But it looks like Germany somehow figured out how to make nuclear fusion a reality with their Waldenstein 7X, or the W7X reactor, which is an experimental stellarator built in Greifswald, Germany by the Max Planck Institute for Plasma Physics. The W7X was built to study a very specific type of fusion reaction known as the stellarator, which is a type of fusion reactor that uses a complex magnetic field to contain and control the extremely hot plasma that is required for fusion to take place. During the year 2015, the W7X reactor was the world's largest stellarator device. It was also developed based on the predecessor Wendelstein 7AS experimental reactor. The goal of this stellarator is to advance stellarator technology. Even though this experimental reactor will not be producing electricity, it will be used to evaluate the main components of a future fusion power plant. Germany was able to do two successful operational phases ending in October 2018, and after that, the reactor was taken offline for several upgrades and will soon resume gradually increasing power and working towards the goal of maintaining enclosure for about half an hour or 30 minutes of continuous plasma discharge. Germany is responsible for 80% of the funding for the entire project, and the rest of the 20% comes from the European Union. 90% of German funding comes from the federal government and 10% from the state government of Mecklenburg-Vorpommern. The total investments for the stellarator itself over a period of 1977 to 2014 amounted to a whopping 370 million euros. This exceeded the original budget estimate mainly because of the initial development phase, which took longer than expected. The reactor was so complex that engineers had to use a supercomputer to design it. The facility is extremely impressive, with a 50-meter diameter vacuum vessel that houses the fusion reaction. It's inside this vessel where you'll find powerful magnets that generate the complex magnetic field that is needed to control and contain the plasma. The facility is also equipped with a number of diagnostic instruments, along with a few cameras that allow researchers to study the plasma and monitor the progress of the fusion reaction. The W7X began its operation way back in December of 2015, and ever since then has been conducting tests to test the capabilities of the stellarator design. These experiments have already produced some of the best results, including the successful production of plasma and sustained operations of the plasma for longer periods of time. The stellarator features a 6.8 kilometer of cooling pipes, a dedicated heating mechanism, and 40 new diagnostics. So within a few years, the fusion facility will be able to perform plasma operations lasting for about 30 minutes, because over the last 3 years, engineers and technicians were controlling the operations, while also learning how to use the W7X to fulfill the technical capabilities of the experiment. So far, the heating of the electrons in the plasma was successful. So electrons should then transfer their energy to the ions, but the ions have yet reached that expected temperature because of what the study of plasma turbulence would be crucial for future research. This is because turbulence can play an important role in expulsion and removal of impurities in the plasma. On the other hand, it can also cause anomalous loss of energy, and researchers are working to understand and control this in the upcoming experiments. But there is still lots of work that needs to be done before fusion can be considered as a viable source of energy. This has to do with the fact that the temperature that is required for fusion to take place is incredibly high, and it is extremely difficult to maintain the stability of a plasma over a long period of time. The amount of energy that is required to initiate and maintain a fusion reaction is currently greater than that amount that is produced by the reaction itself. Nuclear energy comes with its own set of pros and cons. The pros being carbon-free electricity, small land footprint, extremely high power output, and most importantly, a very reliable energy source. Nuclear energy plants take up extremely less physical space. According to the Department of Energy, your typical nuclear facility producing 1,000 megawatts of electricity takes up about 1 square mile of space. To put things in perspective, a wind farm producing the same amount of energy takes about 360 times more land area. And a large-scale solar farm uses about 75 times more space. That means we are looking at 431 wind turbines, or about 3.125 million solar panels. So now you know why governments are excited about nuclear energy. But that's not it. Nuclear power plants also produce high levels of energy compared to most other sources out there, which positions them as an excellent provider for base load electricity. But on the other hand, with the current nuclear reactors that use uranium, and uranium is technically non-renewable, you also need to deal with a high upfront cost and a lot of nuclear waste, as disposing of nuclear waste is no easy task. The worst case scenario would be some malfunction that might have catastrophic outcomes. But overall, it's a great energy source for reliable base payload power for the electrical grid. So with technology that we have today, we might not be able to extract the most out of the fusion reactions. Despite all the challenges, researchers are still optimistic as they believe that with continued research and development, the stellarator design will have the potential to overcome several obstacles and make fusion a reality. If they're successful, the potential rewards are enormous, as fusion could provide a virtually limitless source of clean energy, which will help to power the entire world. Because if it can power the sun, it can power the devices in your house as well, while also combating climate change. The W7X Stellarator Experimental Nuclear Fusion Reactor might be Germany's first big step towards a future where clean and limitless energy would be the norm.